Hey guys, welcome in Mastering Angular 15 from Beginners to Advanced course. In today's lecture, we'll talk about the creating custom form controls with control value accessor. Control value accessor is an interface in Angular that acts as a bridge between the Angular Forms API and a native element in the DOM. Control value accessor allows our custom form controls to interact with the ng model, form control, and form control name. It makes sure the state of the form control stays in sync with the state of our component. If we talk about the core methods of control value accessor, then first we have control value. This is used to set the value in our view or our component when the value changes programmatically. Second is register on change. This method registers a callback function that should be called when the control's value changes in the UI. Third is register on touched. This method registers a callback function that should be called when the control receives a touch event. And then last we have set disabled state. This method is called by the form's API when the control status changes to or from disabled. Depending on the value, it should enable or disable the appropriate DOM element. To use control value accessor, we need providers. Providers are a way to create or deliver services or values to Angular's dependency injection system. They tell Angular how to obtain or create an instance of a dependency. The multi-true option tells Angular's DI system that there can be multiple values for the given token. And this is our student info form. And here we have a country's dropdown, which we have created in our previous lecture by using custom form controls. This is our component which we have created in our previous lecture by using custom form control. And for showing the list of countries in different forms, we are using this app countries dropdown form control. But there is a drawback using this custom form control. We are passing the value by using input and output parameters. But we want to use ng form control or ng model here. And for that, we need to convert it into control value accessor. For the implementation of the control value accessor, first we need to write the providers so that we can inject our component in Angular's dependency injection. Now I'm going to define my provider, provide ng value accessor. This is the key of the provider. Ng value accessor provider basically specifies a class that implements control value accessor interface and is used by Angular to set up the synchronization with the form control. It is usually the class of the component or directive that registers the provider. Next, we need to write multi-true. Using multi-true, we tell Angular that the provider is a multi-provider so that we can create multiple controls against this key. Next, we need to write useExisting, forward reference, and then the lambda expression. Forward ref basically allows to refer to the references which are not yet defined, and it is used when the token which we need to refer for the purposes of DI is declared but not yet defined. In simple words, when we inject this provider in the dependency injection of Angular, at the time our country's drop-down component is not created, its object is not created, so this forward reference will delay it until it's created. So in this case, this component's reference will be saved in the DI, but we will call it when we use it in the HTML file. Next, we need to implement this control value accessor. Implement control value accessor. Now we don't need these extra functions like on, change, input and output parameters, so we can remove them. And let's implement this interface. So we implemented all the functions of this interface like write value, register on change, register on touch, set disabled state. Now I need to define few parameters which we can use for saving the values in these functions. My first variable will be disabled and its type will be boolean. And now I'm going to store false value in this. Then I need few empty functions
which will track the change values. Private onChange is equal, and here I'm going to pass the empty lambda expression. We will use this function for binding our control values. Next, I'm going to write another function onTouched. It's exactly like onChange function, but I'm not going to pass any parametric value here. Now, as we haven't passed any value in these two functions, onChange and onTouched, but then what will be the purpose of writing these functions? The purpose is we are going to use it in the interface functions. In this register onChange function, I'm going to use this.onChange function, and I'm going to pass the value fn in it. Next, I'm going to use this onTouch function in registerOnTouch, and this dot onTouch is equal to fn value. Next, let's implement setDisable state function. And here I'm going to use my isDisabled variable. This dot isDisabled is equal to isDisabled, which came from the parameter. Next, we need to implement the function writeValue, and for that I need another variable. And that variable will be selectedCountry, and its type is string. Now value which came from the form control, it will be saved in this selectedCountry variable. So this dot selectedCountry is equal to obj. Now let's write this onChange function which we have written in our HTML file. In this onChange function we get an event. And first we will set the selectedCountry value. This dot selectedCountry is equal to event.target.value. Next we need to call this dot onChange function here, and in this we need to pass this dot selectedCountry, and in this onChange function we also need to call this dot onTouched. Next we need to change the selected app countries drop down when we call it in different forms. Now we don't need to pass input and output parameters, but simply we will use form control name country here. As you can see, now our code is way simplified than the previous one. Now we don't even need this country change function, so we can remove it. Now we are using it as a simple form control. So here in this form I can pass any value, like here I'm going to pass India, and this default value will be saved in this selected country variable in this write value function. But if we select any value from the drop down on the front end, then this onChange function will be called, and then by this onChange function this value stored in this selected country variable, and this onChange function will call the API's onChange function, and by this it will update the value in this form control. And this is the way our custom control will work by the two-way binding. Now let's run the application and see it on the front end. Now if I change any value in the drop down, it reflects in the stored values. So our control value accessor is working fine. Now if we see why do we need custom form controls. So it will be used to extend the functionality of standard form controls and to encapsulate and reuse form functionality across our application. And then at the end it is used to integrate third-party UI libraries with the Angular forms. So this was the today's lecture. Hope you understand it. If you have any question or query, you can ask in comments. But if this lecture is helpful for you, then guys, please like, subscribe and share my channel. Thanks for watching.